I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. We're going to be making pineapple cloud tropical fruit salad. I think you're going to like it. Starts out with pineapple. I have 1/20-ounce can of pineapple chunks that have been drained. So I'm just going to put them in this bowl that I plan to serve this in. Unless if it gets messy, then I'll put it in another bowl. So try to get all of this out. And then move on to the next fruit, which is mandarin oranges. I have an 11-ounce can, which has been drained, and you notice I saved the juice from the pineapple. I will be using it, but I did not save the juice from the orange segments. Just put those in. You see they're a little watery from the draining. I will drain all of this at the end before I put my topping on, so don't worry if there's a little extra that could be drained off. The next thing is maraschino cherries. Now I have a 10-ounce jar. I don't necessarily use all of those, so I'm just going to see what it looks like. And again, I drained it, but there's a little bit of leftover juice. I really think that's enough. So if you want the whole jar, that's fine. But I don't really think it needs it for this salad. So this gets set aside. And actually it gets refrigerated, so I'll be covering this with plastic wrap and putting it in the refrigerator until everything else is ready. So just remember, we have fruits standing by. They're tropical sort of fruits. I'm going to take a saucepan, and in that saucepan I'm going to put 1/2 cup of sugar. That's just plain old sugar, 1/2 cup. I'm going to mix with that 2 tablespoons of flour. It can be self-rising or all-purpose, it doesn't matter. That you need 2 tablespoons, and then stir those around and they will easily combine. And then you're going to add your drained pineapple juice. When you drain one of these cans, and by the way, this was in its own juice, it was not in heavy syrup or anything like that, so no sugar was added, and I like to do it like that to save on the sugar. But you will get about 3/4 cup. So I would even measure it. If I'm getting more than that or less than that, I'd squeeze those until I could get some more juice out of them. More than that, I would discard it or drink it or whatever. But it doesn't go in here. 3/4 cup of pineapple juice that generally would come from your drained pineapple. So you stir this together. I think I'll go ahead and I will be stirring as I cook this on the stove. So I'm adding the last ingredient here, which is 2 well-beaten eggs. So I've just taken some, actually I had some jumbo eggs here. They don't have to be jumbo. It would work if you had small eggs. So anywhere from small to jumbo, 2 of them well-beaten. Add that in and then mix it together. And then take it to the cooktop. Put it on one of your burners and turn that on. And I'm going to turn it on probably to medium since I'm here to watch it continually. I want to bring it to a boil and boil it for maybe 1 or 2 minutes. My pineapple pudding is done and I have cooked it probably 3 or 4 minutes. I started it on medium heat and then I turned it down to low. And after I had it on low heat, I stirred it continually to keep those lumps out. And you can see it's a nice, smooth, velvety texture. And you know it's done when it looks like it is of the texture that you would expect to have for pudding. So a nice pineapple pudding that has been made from our leftover pineapple juice. I'm going to bring it over here. And all I have to do at this point is let it cool down a little bit. Not even to room temperature necessarily, cover it with aluminum foil or plastic wrap and place it in the refrigerator. So both of my 2 main components are going to be refrigerated and then we'll come back for the finale. It's been about 5 hours since I put the ingredients for my pineapple cloud tropical fruit salad in the refrigerator. And you see here I have the covered fruits. And here I have the covered pineapple pudding that we made. I meant to get a little dish out to pour off any excess juice. Remember, when we put these in, we had drained them, but usually there is some juice that collects in the bottom. You see that? You do not want that in your topping. It's going to water it down and will really make a big effect on your topping. So get that out. And now we have truly drained our fruit. Now, coming over here, I'm just going to give this a stir, get it off, loose off the bottom, and then I'm going to go to another ingredient. Well, looks like I've got two sets of beaters, but one of these is chilled. I got this out of the freezer. I put it in the freezer about an hour ago, and along with it, I put 1/2 pint of whipping cream. That would be 1 cup worth, and it has started to make ice crystals around the edge, so that may be a little difficult to get out, but I've got a spoon here to dig it out. What I plan to do is to whip the cream. I think our whipping cream is ready. I'm going to turn this off, and I've been whipping this for about 5 minutes, but you cannot take the time as your measurement. What you have to do is look at the whipped cream. Add one more ingredient to the fruit mixture, which is not a fruit, but it is just regular miniature marshmallows. You can see this is just a bag of marshmallows, and you can do from 1 to 2 cups. So I've chosen 1 1/2 cups. We really like marshmallows in this, so that's kind of maybe a lot, but you can go as low as 1 cup and as high as 2 cups. Now what I need to do is put these two together. It's better to fold the whipped cream into the pudding. So you don't want to squash the whipped cream. You want to keep all of that air that you just whipped into it. So try to make a gentle motion, bringing the pineapple up from the bottom. You see it swirl through the whipped cream. This is going to be an elegant and lovely flavor. And then what I'm going to do is use this as, I would say a topping, but I'm going to mix it in once I get it topped for my fruit and the marshmallows. In order to do this, if I want to save this for my serving bowl, I think what I'll have to do is place it in my beating bowl, so I can do the stirring, because that sometimes gets all messy and you wouldn't want to serve from that. So I'm saving this to be a clean bowl, and at the same time I'm accomplishing getting these two blended together. So just pour that nice pineapple-y whipped cream sauce over the top. It's so wonderful and lovely. Salad, you can consider it as a dessert if you want to, because it's nice and sweet, but I call it a tropical fruit salad. So let's come over here and just again fold. Now I'm going to pour this into my serving dish, and you see how messy it is, so that's why I didn't want to use my serving dish to do the actual blending. Pour that right into the serving dish. Bring this over toward the center to let you see what it looks like. I don't want to do too much blending here because it will kind of mess up the appearance, but let's smooth it off on the top a little bit. And there is Betty's Pineapple Cloud Tropical Fruit Salad. Now if you'd like to see it served, what you're going to do is just take a serving spoon, dip down into it, try to get some of everything. Put it in a little dish like this, or a big dish. Use a spoon, and then when you take a bite of it, you can't get all of this at once, but you can get quite a bit of it, and just take a bite. It tastes delicious. I think you'll like it.